Are we gonna usher in a new era on Netflix? You remind me of a film that I once knew.
Stop.
That's the only Usher song I know. Anywhere's Bucket Hats. And that is really all I know about Usher.
How about, it's gonna burn for me to say this, but it's coming from the heart. It's been a long time coming, but we the band fell apart. I really wanna work this out, but I
don't really got to fart. I'm in the trash.
Welcome to the trash. Watch the trash.
That's, no, that's, what's that other one? That's,
shut up!
That was Fraggle Rock.
Fraggle Rock, House of Usher, you tell me what the difference is.
A lot of Muppets.
Murderers, yeah.
So, House of Usher is an Edgar Allan Poe story, right? I'm sure you're
yes, this is Mike
it.
Flanagan's adaptation of Edgar Allan Poe.
The Dropkick Murphys guy?
Mike Flanagan did, he did a bunch of movies. Did you ever see Oculus?
Yes, I loved Oculus.
Yeah, he did Oculus for TV shows. He did Haunting of Hill House.
Didn't see that.
He did Midnight Mass, the TV show, which was very good. You'd like that one a lot.
I probably would, but you know what? People keep saying how good it is, and so I'm never going to watch it.
He's also done a couple other really good. He did like Ouija, Origin of Evil, which was a pretty good sequel.
I do like Ouijas, but you had me at Oculus. I love Oculus. But now,
Hush.
House
you ever
of
saw
Usher
Hush?
Is one of my favorites, so it's going to be interesting to see how he adapts this. It's not really a scary story. It's an ominous gothic tale.
He loves his gothic flair, though, so I think that makes sense.
Let's see. And let's roll that beautiful bean footage.
It's going to burn for me to say this, but a house of Usher divided against itself cannot stand.
It's time.
Finally, all right.
Oh, well.
We start with a funeral. I like that.
It's time.
It's Vader time!
It's time.
It's Vader time.
It's time.
Oh my god.
Oh, look at that! It's a raven.
You know how they say that they're in their stone age.
Usher crime family. Usher crime family? Than ever before. Oh, so they're criminals now.
Well, they might have potentially always been. But what's very interesting is they're all seemingly alive?
On the streets. So the funeral happens later.
Do you guys, we really should get together?
Well, I mean, the book, there's like only two left. The whole point is that
the
line's over.
But I mean, like, this is what's gonna. You gotta start at the beginning. Oh, he's at the fucking Overlook.
If he's Roderick Usher, he's already older than he was in the story. And he dies in that.
Yeah. Well,
so this is nothing related to the story at all. They're just barring names.
Well, I think what they're going to do here is I think they're going to use it as a framework to adapt other Poe short stories.
None of that makes sense.
Maybe it will. Maybe it'll work.
I'm going to say it's not going to work.
I don't know. If Mike Flanagan actually directed every episode...
Your brother's dead.
My heart will go on tweets. We'll pat it out.
Hilarious. That is true. That's what I do when it has death.
Thoughts and prayers.
Ooh! Yeah, not testy.
What did you do?
Well, you either die the hero or you see
you live
long enough to become some sort of Nazi-esque villain, Luke Skywalker.
Why is Mark Hamill in a show about family? He doesn't care about family. Just ask his granddaughter.
Well, Holly, you still can't you?
Mm-hmm.
If we don't stop her, we won't have a family left.
And Mark just believes that what doesn't kill you makes you strong. Hey, I want one of those clocks. What are those called?
Cat?
Nevermore.
It is a special
Nevermore.
One. Hey, you love Nevermore.
I do. World Dane.
Are you involved in this project?
But, no, World Dane's been dead for a couple years.
Oh, wow.
Unfortunately.
Told you, he's over.
Yeah.
He's over
50 years old and dead. We should really get World Dane for this Nevermore TV show. I think kids would get a kick out of seeing the original singer. I keep telling you, he's over 50 years old and he's dead.
We just beat that.
I know, but we did it in full context now.
Oh, boring trailer.
Yeah,
this Mike Flanagan might be pretty good at the Dropkick Murphys, but he doesn't seem to be very good at making movies or TV shows.
I don't know whoever cut that trailer.
Except Oculus, which was good.
Hush was really good, too. I think you would like Hush if you ever saw that.
What does this feel like?
This feels like it's going to be a waste of my time based on the trailer.
Like, what's another author where you would just start jamming all their stories together?
Stephen King, they did it with Castle Rock on Hulu, but that worked.
Maybe, I guess, if there's some explanation for why all of his monsters are in one place at
they
once.
They kind
of
did a good job with that, is my understanding. I haven't seen it, but I heard it worked.
You know, but it's like, Poe's stuff is also snapshotty. It's like, so what? Someone's going to be bricked in here. There'll be a pit and a pendulum for one scene. Yeah. There'll be all heart under a floorboard.
But most of it's going to be nightmare sequences, though. It's not even actually going to happen in the show.
But a lot of it's just patting yourself on the back for seeing how many Poe references you could sneak into a story, which is... pretty much what? Just, well, I don't know, some kind of Succession type story.
Yeah, it looks like something. Succession. Yeah, it looks like Succession.
Succession
meets
Game of Thrones-ish, maybe, where maybe they're trying to
House of the Dragon more recently.
You know, where it's some internal family conflict that half of them are probably screwing each other secretly.
Ew.
The Raven watches.
Yeah.
You know, they're in their Stone Age.
Yeah.
So
it don't matter.
Probably ravens can pleasure themselves. I don't know. There's a thing. For you to find out.
That's not how. I don't think
they're in their Stone Age. They're
let's get back to
this. Learning.
Do you think though that this is going to be a case where?
I think everything about this is going to be dumb.
I'm not actually.
And it's going to ride on the fact that he
did Haunting of Hill House.
That he didn't he fairly accurately adapt what was already a great book. It's already a 10 times better movie.
I will tell you that I think the TV show adaptation of Haunting Hill House is as close to like a perfect TV show as I've ever seen. I really like
it. I might watch it.
I really like how like they set like, because you have the number of kids, so they spend one episode.
We're not talking about that.
But I am a little bit, because I wonder if the structure of this will follow that, where we'll get, because it looks like the cast is too big. Right? Doesn't it look like too big a cast to focus on each character appropriately and well?
It's certainly so big for the fall of House of Usher.
Yeah.
It's
so I don't know if we're going to.
How about if you just called it House of Usher? I already like that better. Just call it the House of Usher.
The rise and fall of the House of Usher.
The point is that this is going to have to show a rise before it shows a fall.
So, yeah.
So you could have just called it House of Usher if you're going to tell the whole story.
Maybe it will start at the end and then they'll do a cheap flashback thing and it's going to take all the tension out of
it. And what house is going to split in half, literally? I mean, the house does split in half, literally.
Yeah. But, I mean, I don't know. I'll still watch it. I mean, I'll still watch it.
Ask me if I'm going to watch it. Ask me if I'm going to watch this.
Are you going to watch this?
Nevermore!
I thought you were going to yell nope for some reason and bring it back to that joke from last year.
Nevermore.
This is really why I got to pitch these things past me first.